हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एप्टी प्लस एडिटोरियल एनालिसिस। सो इस वीडियो में समझने की कोशिश करेंगे जो इंपॉर्टेंट एडिटोरियल है फ्रॉम द हिंदू एज वेल एज फ्रॉम द इंडियन एक्सप्रेस, वो जो न्यूज़ है, जो एडिटोरियल है आपके एग्जाम्स के लिए कैसे इंपॉर्टेंट हो सकती है। एंड विल बी ऑल्सो लुकिंग इन टू द एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द जनरल स्टडीज पेपर 1, 2 एंड 3। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग आई वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू इन्फॉर्म दैट विल बी डिस्कसिंग सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वुड बी रेलेवेंट फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन। देयर विल बी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द करंट इवेंट, स्टैटिक क्वेश्चन एंड द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन। So there is a wholesome where it can definitely impact your preparation for the prelims examination. Now we have launched a complete mock test series for civil services 2020. So you can enroll this course both online as well as offline. There is 40 sectional tests, 12 current affair tests, 5 previous year question and 13 full length tests is there. For more details you can refer to the contact number or you can visit our website also. And you all, those of you who want to participate in the answer writing challenge, so we have our initiative called IS Gyan, where you can participate and write your answer. You can post your answer. By 6 p.m. we'll be having the model answer by our expert and academician. So definitely it would be an answer enhancing your answer writing skill. So please find the link of the answer writing challenge in the description of this video. And आप में से जो लोग हमारे एप्टी प्लस टेलीग्राम ऑफिशियल चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करना चाहते हैं, सो द बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस इज यू विल बी गेटिंग द इंपॉर्टेंट PDF compilations एंड ऑल अदर नोटिफिकेशन रिलेटेड टू एग्जामिनेशन। सो डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब द एप्टी प्लस ऑफिशियल टेलीग्राम चैनल एंड डू लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब दिस वीडियो इन द यूट्यूब चैनल सो दैट यू गेट द इंपॉर्टेंट नोटिफिकेशन व्हेन वी अपलोड एनी ऑफ द न्यू वीडियोज रिलेटेड टू द एग्जामिनेशन। So let's get started with the important news for the day. So the first is Obama was right about the Iran. So this topic and this talks about how the carrot and stick policy that was being dealt with the Tehran. Okay, so this is on the background of this. So इसमें बताया गया है कि कैसे डोनाल्ड ट्रंप ने एक जो unilateralism का जो issues है, talking about the regional border that has been discussed, and there has been a many up and downs when it's come to the US एंड तेहरान इशूज़। बेसिकली जो ईरान के फॉरन मिनिस्टर्स थे मोहम्मद जवेद जाफरी, इन्हें इज गिवन अ स्पीच एंड स्टॉक लाइक दो जो स्टॉकहोम इंटरनेशनल पीस रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट हैं, उन्होंने कहा कि जो अनप्रेडिक्टेबिलिटी जो है दैट विल लीड्स टू म्यूचुअल अनप्रेडिक्टेबिलिटी। ठीक है, और कहीं ना कहीं जो अनप्रेडिक्टेबिलिटी है दैट इज़ अ कैथोटिक। ठीक है, तो इट कैन बी अ सुसाइडल एंड दे हैव क्लेम दैट द US प्रेजिडेंट इज अप्रोचिंग टू अ पॉलिसी दैट इज कॉल्ड मैक्सिमम प्रेशर्स। तो बेसिकली ये जो न्यूज़ है दैट अगेन कैन बी इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर योर जनरल स्टडीज पेपर 2। ठीक है, जहाँ पे मैक्सिमम प्रेशर पॉलिसीज के बैकग्राउंड में बात की गई है। और अगर मैं थोड़ा सा और इसको डिटेल में बताऊँ तो द मैक्सिमम रेजिस्टेंस व्हेन इट्स कम टू द US साइड, बेसिकली अगर बात करूँ P51 जो यूरोपियन यूनियन की जो मीटिंग हुई थी, ठीक है, इसमें से भी US ने बेसिकली दे हैव सैंक्शन फ्रॉम द ईरान न्यूक्लियर डील, ओके, फ्रॉम द इंटरनेशनल क्लेरिफिकेशन। एंड अगेन व्हेन इट्स कम टू द अनदर इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड, तो देर विल बी मेनी डाउनफॉल व्हेन इट्स कम टू ईरान एज वेल एज द तेहरान इशूज, राइट। और जो द रिलीज ऑफ द अदर मिलिट्री रिस्पॉन्सेज आर देयर, तो वहाँ पर भी इट विल बी अ हाई रिस्क फॉर देम। ठीक है, एंड दिस इज़ द ऑल द एडिटोरियल एंटायरली कंसर्न अबाउट द US एंड द तेहरान इशूज़। ओके, सो हाउ द कैरेट एंड स्टिक पॉलिसी इज देयर एंड देयर अदर इमर्जिंग इशूज इट्स कम टू इंडिया एज वेल, आप उसमें इंडिया के एस्पेक्ट को भी इंक्लूड कर सकते हो। फाइन, नाउ द सेकेंड एडिटोरियल विच इज रिपोर्टेड इन द हिंदू टॉक्स अबाउट द सेल्फ इन्फ्लेक्टेड इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ। सो दिस इज ऑन द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द सेवलर रिकमेंडेशन विच वॉज देयर बाय द गवर्नमेंट। अगर मैं इसमें बताऊँ जो 2014 में जो गवर्नमेंट थी, जो न्यू गवर्नमेंट द प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी के अंदर, तो व्हाट ही हैज टॉक्ड लाइक कि व्हाट कुड बी अ बेस्ट पॉसिबल द फिजिबल द वे आउट, द व्हाट कुड बी द इकोनॉमिक वे आउट, व्हाट कुड बी द इकोनॉमिक रोड मैप सो दैट वी कुड अचीव द फुल पोटेंशियल ऑफ अर इकोनॉमी। तो इसमें एक छोटी सी एग्जाम्पल भी दी गई है कि जैसे जो सेक्रेटरीज होते हैं, बेसिकली जो टॉप ब्यूरोक्रेट्स हैं, दे हैव गिवन अ सजेशन। तो ही हैज आज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज आज कि क्या एक आइडियल रोड मैप होना चाहिए। तो इट वॉज बिंग टोल्ड कि वॉट एवर वी हैव डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस मीटिंग दैट कुड बी आइडियली द बेस्ट पॉसिबल वे टू गेट द इकोनॉमिक टू द स्ट्रीम लाइन। तो बेसिकली इसमें ये बताया गया है कि कैसे जो मेजर चीज़ें बताई गई थी, जो रिकमेंडेशन इकोनॉमिक्स के द्वारा या फिर जो स्टेक होल्डर्स जो पर्टिकुलर कंसर्न डिपार्टमेंट्स हैं या जो सीनियर ब्यूरोक्रेट्स हैं, उनके जो मेजर्स बताए गए थे दैट वॉज नॉट बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट। ठीक है, नॉट बाय द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफिस। सो दिस इज ऑन द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ दिस। एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द अदर इनिशिएटिव विच वॉज देयर कि हाउ द पॉलिसी पैरालिसिस कैन बी एंडेड, बिकॉज जब UPA गवर्नमेंट थी मनमोहन सिंह के अंदर, एट द दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम अगेन इट वॉज अ रिवाइविंग सिचुएशन, इट वॉज बिंग कॉल्ड दैट इकोनॉमी थोड़ी रिपेयर कर रही है। बट अभी प्रेजेंट कंटेक्स्ट में देखी जाए तो देर इज़ अ डाउनफॉल। अभी जो GDP ग्रोथ है दैट इज़ ऑलमोस्ट क्लोज टू 5%, सो इट इज़ वेरी नॉट। अगर मैं बात करूँ जो हमारा इकोनॉमिक जो हमारा जो $5 trillion इकोनॉमी की जो टारगेट है, $5 trillion इकोनॉमी की जो टारगेट है दैट कैन ओनली बी अचीव्ड वंस इंडिया हैज़ नो जीडीपी ग्रोथ रेट ऑफ बिटवीन 9 to 12%. It is expected it should be more than 12%. You can see the suggestion which was not been included from the expert advice. ठीक है, और अगर इसमें थोड़ी सी ये भी बात की गई है, जैसे जो RBI ने जो जो इनकरेक्टिव जो मेजर्स थे दैट वाज एक्ट एज अ डिक्रीमेंटल टू द इकोनॉमी ऑफ द इंडिया, जैसे अगर डीमोनेटाइजेशन की इश्यूज है दैट वाज ऑलरेडी बीइंग टेकन अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द RBI गवर्नर मिस्टर रघुराम राजन कि द गवर्नमेंट शुड नॉट टेक इन टू द एक्शन व्हेन इट्स कम टू द डीमोनेटाइजेशन, ऐसे डिसीजन से बचना चाहिए. उसके बाद जो GST का इशूज था, अगेन देर वॉज अ ब्रीफिंग फ्रॉम मिस्टर विजय खेलकर, सो ही टोल्ड दैट कि दिस टाइप ऑफ इनिशिएटिव शुड नॉट बी taken place. So there was again a caution from the many quarters of the expert, but despite the fact government has not taken it very seriously, and this is what I cannot say ki this is the only reason from the economic slowdown, but this could be one of the best possible reasons that is what our country is facing now, right? So this was there from the Hindu. Now moving to the second editorial, now talking about the shaking the foundation of the fake news. So this is again a very important news when it's come to your general studies paper 3. And precisely I'll say it can be also used for your ethics paper. तो वहाँ पे इस चीज़ों को यूज़ कर सकते हो कि हाउ आर नो फेक न्यूज़ कैन बी नो वेरी डिक्रीमेंटल टू द सोसाइटी एंड व्हेन इट्स कम टू ना टर्मोइल एंड अदर इश्यूज़ लाइक पीपल आर नॉट वेरी एजुकेटेड. सो आप इंस्टेंटली अभी आप देखोगे रिसेंट इनिशिएटिव में व्हाट्सएप ने या और भी लोगों ने दे आर ब्लॉकिंग थ्रू द एल्गोरिथम एंड दे आर एडवर्टीजिंग ऑल्सो कि आप जो भी ऐसे न्यूज़ है उसको तुरंत फॉरवर्ड ना करें. सो वील बी लुकिंग इन टू इन डेप्थ ऑफ दिस न्यूज़. सो इट वुड बी इंडीड ग्रेट फॉर योर एथिक्स पेपर एज वेल एज ऐसे आप वहाँ पर भी यूज़ कर सकते हो. नाउ एक अदर शॉर्ट आर्टिकल है द गुजरात मॉडल डिस्पोज नो गुजरात मॉडल के बारे में थोड़ा सा डिस्कशन है. तो दिस अगेन कैन बी यूज्ड नो दिस टॉक्स अबाउट दिस इज बाय मेधा नो दिस टॉक्स अबाउट बेसिकली व्हाट इज द सरदार सरोवर द इनिशिएटिव दैट हैज डेफिनेटली इम्पैक्टेड अ लॉट ऑफ द पीपल. ओके एंड इट हैज इंडीड हेल्प टू इमर्जिंग नो एज अ सबमर्जेंस जोन. Fine. And Gujarat being the other countries, basically in the state where Narmada has its own importance. Fine. So it also talk about the emergence of the sea water and the primary beneficiaries who are there, the state who will be benefited from this. So the entire thing is discussed. This again can be important for your general studies paper 2 and 3. Okay. Now when it's come to the inter river water dispute, it can be used there as well. And it the basic note of this is that we'll be celebrating 150th anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, and it's also called that the God forbid that the India should ever take the industrialization after the manner of the West. Okay, so how we could achieve because there are almost none people who are millions of people who would be voting, like we could come up with a proper conclusion, and we can definitely enhance when it's come to the overall inclusive development of our country. Now there's a short article which is there that talks about the Nigeria issues. Okay, so this is again not that important, but I would rather request ki aap ek bar padh sakte ho Nigeria wars in the wild, you know, polio virus approach. So how they have achieved a target so that they have declared as a polio free this year. So this again can be important for your prelims examination, and when it's come to the general studies paper, you can use this point in the general studies paper 3 when it's come to the health section of the general studies. Okay, so this can be used there as well. Now taking at the glimpse from the Indian Express, so the first editorial which is there in the Indian Express talks about the grassroots reformers. Okay, so this is by Mr. Yogendra L. Alga. He talks about the famous B.N. Yendunkar. So you must be aware the recent demise of him, and he was a very a tall leader. He was an IAS officer, senior bureaucrat who has done a lot for the country. He has done a lot for the country, and you must be aware that he's the father of Satya Nadella, who is a Microsoft CEO. Okay, so the recent demise of his, and the whole article is written on the background of that, ki how he mentored the generation of civil servants, and he was a father of Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella, and being an IAS officer, he has B.N. Yendunkar was a man of the integrity who actively worked for the marginalized society through his stories, and he has contributed a lot to the society. When it's come to the Hyderabad, the initiatives like selling of the rice for 2 rupees or 1 rupees was being initiated by him only. So a famous scheme that also include 2 kg rice. The scheme itself was named as 2 kg rice. So this is the entirely discussed about as an personality, as an individual, where you can use this as an ethics paper. Ethics mein iski aap use kar sakte ho. Fine. Now the second editorial which is there in the Indian Express talks about the age-old replacement. So this is on the background of the renovation work going in Delhi. So those of you who are residing in Delhi must be aware of the places which I'll be naming. So here we talked about how the Red Fort wali areas, talking about the surrounding areas of the Red Fort, is being again renovated from the Mughal era to more and the more of the contemporaries. And Delhi mein bahut bhi aise ilaka hai jaise Jorbagh ka ilaka hai, ya agar India Gate ki baat kare, jisko we called as a Lutyen Delhi. So there's again more of work which is going for. The proposal is to reinvent the Delhi. Okay, so this is on the background of that. Again, not very much important from the examination point of view, but definitely you can read this. Now the second editorial, which is there in the op-ed page, the idea page basically, it talks about the frozen map and the diplomatic opening. So there's a, you know, the issues of abrogation of Article 370 in the Jammu and Kashmir and the opportunity to revisit a 4-point plan has been discussed. This again can be important. Those who have not included the point from the Article 370 or 35A can also read this. This can be an important one. Okay? So what could be the demand? The people demands. Okay. How the democracy can be imparted there. The more participation of the people could be there. So a 4-point can has been discussed. So this again can be important for your general studies. Paper 2. Now the short article which is there in the Indian Express talks about for the demographic dividend. Okay, so then talking about the demographic dividend, so it talks about what should be the focuses on the health, education, women and other population so that we could increase the women participation as well as workforce participation. Okay, so participation of the people is very important and India become the most populous country. Now, if TFR ki baat kare to thoda sa data hai that can be important for you. I have already made a separate video jahan pe maine TFR ko bahut acche se samjhaya, to wo video ko aap refer kare where the TFR ki jo rates hai jaise 5.9 early 60 में थे, now it's back to 2.4%. So the entire thing has been discussed. These are data driven. और थोड़ी सी बात की गई कि how we can potentially use our demographic dividend. Okay, so the policy should be there so that the entire potential of the country can be used in the right direction. There should be a targeted district जहाँ पे records TFR को ना measures किया जाए. जहाँ तक बात की जाए Muslims populations की, so that can be adequately taken with a cautious और जहाँ पर population surplus बहुत ज़्यादा ना हो. So this is on the background of this. Again, this can be important for your general studies paper 3. Now this is a editorial which is a critique of the government. So the changing time. So you can read this. I don't find it to be very relevant for the examination point of view. So ek bar aap padke isko, you can skip it also. Now taking to our important editorial, that the second foundation of the fake news. So the news that is being reported talks about the fake news and its impact on the society. So we'll be looking into the entire depth. So basically the entire editorial concerned about the Menace of the fake news. So what exactly, what could be the decremental impact of the fake news? So what is fake news? You need to understand ki fake news hota kya. See, this it is a fictitious, ek tarah ka aisa kalpanik as article media that are being deliberately circulated. Theek hai, ya to WhatsApp mein ho, Facebook mein ho, Twitter mein ho, ya Instagram mein, kisi bhi madhyam se the news is being deliberately taken to the mass of the people. ठीक है, और कोशिश ये की जानी चाहिए कि हाउ वी शुड कम बैक दैट न्यूज़. जो जो प्रीऑक्यूपेशनल है, जो टेक्नोलॉजिकल प्लेटफॉर्म्स है, या तो वो पॉलिटिकल क्लास हो, या तो मीडिया हो, या भी किसी भी तरह से किसी और माध्यम से जिस चीज़ों से ना दैट इम्पैक्टिंग द डेमोक्रेसी, द नॉर्मल लाइफ ऑफ द पीपल, दैट इज डेफिनेटली बींग हाईजैक्ड बाय द फेक न्यूज़. ठीक है, तो द एंटायर एडिटोरियल सराउंड अराउंड दिस, विल बी लुकिंग टू द अदर इम्पैक्ट ऑफ दिस एज वेल. तो गवर्नमेंट और जो पॉलिटिकल एक्टर्स हैं, दे हैव दे ऑलवेज इन्वेस्ट इन द डिस इन्फॉर्मेशन कैंपेन. वो देखो बहुत हर पॉलिटिकल पार्टी, दे आर नॉट मेकिंग द पीपल अवेयर ऑफ द फैक्ट विच इज़ गोइंग. ठीक है, कहीं ना कहीं उनको डिस इन्फॉर्मेशन दी जा रही है टू बिल्ड अ नैरेटिव ऑफ देयर चॉइस. पॉलिटिकल पार्टी कोशिश ये कर रहे हैं कि वो अपने हिसाब से चीज़ों को मोल्ड करने, अपने हिसाब से अपने वोट बैंक के हिसाब से बातें की जाती है. ठीक है, और अगर मैं इंस्टीट्यूशनल की बात करूँ, जैसे जो मीडिया है या जो न्यूज़ मीडिया है, दे आर नॉट टेकिंग अ प्रो एक्टिव रोल. दे आर नॉट एक्टिंग एज अ आर्बिट्रेटर ऑफ द रियल न्यूज़. ओके, रैदर इट इज़ बिंग टोल्ड दैट द मीडिया इज बिंग अ paid, it's becoming a paid news. Okay, so definitely it's make people inclined towards the fake news, because every people is not aware what exactly is happening. They are completely dependent on the news and the people they are following. Okay, so this is from there. Now there's a confirmation bias. What is confirmation bias? अगर कोई भी news आ रही है, people do not take care about the finding of the truth, कि उस news की validity क्या है, उसकी truth क्या है, उस news के पीछे rational क्या है, it's not being taken care of. So people do not cross-check it, people do not cross-examine it. Okay, that is called confirmation bias. तो वहाँ पर problem arise होती है. Whatever news which is being reported to you, you need to confirm it, you need to make sure that the news is coming from the authentic sources. तो आप उसको cross-check करो, ये नहीं कि whichever is coming to your WhatsApp and you are directly taking action on it. Okay, so confirmative bias is again one of the major problems. Now, what should be the measures to check it? Now, what could be the check and balances? So the first and check and balances would be ki jo badi badi company hain, jaise Facebook ki baat karu ya Twitter ki baat karu ya to YouTube ki baat karu, they should come with a, they should show a proactive role, you know, ki what the jo fake news ka jo platform hai wahan pe inko kaam karne ki bahut zarurat hai. Now they should also be re-advised to work with the algorithm, jo algorithm hai, to ensure that such content do not have the predominance in the society. Wo kahin na kahin society ko dominate karne kare, it cannot impact the violence in the society, jo normal tension hai, jo basically jo calm of the society hai, jo pace of the democracy hai, cannot be impacted. Fine. Now jo newly introduced, basically agar main baat karu jo forward messages on WhatsApp hai, that also be taken care of, because recent abhi WhatsApp ne, they have blocked, there's an advisory from the WhatsApp as well ki aap koi bhi aise news ko turant forward na kare until and that it is a valid, is a truth news, aur us tarah ke kuch bhi news aati hai, you need to report same to the WhatsApp. So these are some of the measures that is taken by the some of the largest online platform or the public platform like Facebook, WhatsApp and YouTube. Or education is very important, educating the user, educating the people through whom this message is being consumed. So jo consumer hai, jo end consumer hai, wahan pe ek verification tool ki bahut zarurat hai, and we definitely need to educate the end users. Okay, so this could be the some of the check and balances. Now coming to the rebuttal and removal. See, dekho rebuttal kya hai? Rebuttal ek tarah ka form hai jahan we check the news, jo fake news hai we need to cross examine it. Okay, and if we find there is an error, mismatch, any malicious editing is there, any misattribution is there, we need to remove it. So this is a method called rebuttal and removal. So these are the some of the important measures, if important, if taken place in the right direction, can lead to the avoidance of the fake news in the country. Now what could be the way forward? So the first way forward would be definitely the need is to that the primary news that is there, we need to reboot it, we need to remove the fake news, and we need to educate the people. So the first would be the rebuttal, the second would be the removal of the news, and third would be the educating of the public is very important. Like I, you and me, everyone need to, you know, have a good education. Agar aapke samne koi aise log aate hain, you know, who are imparting the wrong messages or wrong pictures or anything, so you can ask them, you can educate them that these things are not think good, because now ultimately what is happening, like an individual and drop by drop can definitely lead to a big impact in the society, right? Or zarurat ye bhi hai ki there should be a grievance redressal mechanism jahan pe ek arbitration spaces ho, we need to resolve the issue. Okay, or there should be an stringent law as well. Agar main digital media ki baat karu to there should be an increasing scrutiny about the feedbacks and the content. Okay, kuch bhi nahi hona chahiye digital media mein. Now, people on their official pages, talking about the Facebook pages, talking about the Twitter pages, basically the political parties, they have many other things which they portrayed in their news. So wahan pe ek level of filter hona chahiye. Now the online platform, jaise ki agar content distribution ki baat kare to wahan pe ek create system hona chahiye, ek filter hona chahiye, jo fake news hai that should be easily filtered and it cannot be reached to the consumer, the end of the people, okay, to the masses. Or using the creator, the hate content hai, usko bhi we need to remove it, and we could have a serious, you know, there could be a section of the Indian penal code, jaise ki aap jaise IT act mein 66A hai, to wahan pe us tarah ke kuch important penal act ke through we can stop this thing happening in the country, right? So this could be the way forward. So I think this was an important editorial. Any questions can be interlinked with this topic. Aap se pooch sakte hain ki how the fake news and the decremental in the society, what could be the best way then so that we can stop the revealing of the fake news or the spreading of the fake news, or you are posted as in ethics, they can ask you ki agar aap posted as in district magistrate or superintendent of police, to wahan pe aap how will stop the, you know, the spreading of the fake news. So this can be used many general studies also or ethics ke paper mein bhi. Now moving to the important questions of the day. So the first question is, you have to tell me which of the following king patronized the Sharmadhan traditions. Okay, this is from the Indian culture. So this is a static one. Okay, this is from the Indian culture. You have to tell me which among the following is correct answer. Is Chandragupta Maurya, Agnimitra, Ashoka or Devvarmana. So isme jo correct answer hai, aap please iske jo video ke comment section mein mujhe bataye ki iska correct answer kya hai. Now the second question is, with reference to the micro irrigation, which among the following statement is correct. Ye question geography ka hai, that is for 2011. So which statement is correct? The neutralizer loss can be reduced. It is the only means for irrigation of dry and land farming, and in some areas farming residing the groundwater level can be checked. So which among the following is the correct answer, whether one is correct, both 2 and 3, 1 and 3 or 1, 2 and 3, which is the correct answer. This is for 2011. I'll be using basically from 2011 to 2019, so that it can definitely enhance your understanding of the prelims question. Fine. So participate in the question answer series and write your answer in the comment of this video. So this was the editorial analysis from the day. If you have any other concern, do let me know. I'll be more than happy to answer your queries, and do participate. And thank you so much for listening. We'll be meeting in the next video with some of the important relevant context for the examination as well. And indeed, it would be a pleasure to see you again. Thank you so much for listening.